Everyone, in this video I am going to deal about sixth program of computer network lab. The title of the program is implement and study the performance of CDMA on NS2 or NS3 using stack called CallNet or equivalent environment. So first we need to set up the simulation environment. For that we need to take about all the general parameters, AQM parameters and floating statistics and all. So here we need to specify both upward link and downward downlink propagation. So now we need to specify the downlink bandwidth in BPS. So for this program we need to specify the downlink bandwidth as 384,000, and that is bandwidth with an uplink is 64,000. So likewise we need to specify the delay also. The delay for uplink is 1.150 milliseconds and downlink is 150. Both are equal. And next we need to specify the buffer size. So here 20 is the buffer size, and also we need to specify the output of the trace file in a write mode. Next we need to close the trace file. Then we need to set up the nodes. Set nodes is, within square bracket I am writing $ns node, means that a node circle will be created and it will be labeled as is. And next mobile node, mobile station will be created, then base station 1 will be created, base station 2 will be created, and in IP internet protocols will be created. Then I need to specify the link between two different nodes. So for that I am using duplex link. The role of the duplex link is used for bidirectional communication. So duplex link is established between IP as well as BS1, then BS1 with the MS, then MS with BS2, then BST to IS. So means that from directly IP to IS not possible. So I am making the communication between each and every nodes. Then I put cell topology, means the whenever we deployed all the nodes, it will be in the cell topology format. Then afterwards we need to specify the buffer size between uplink and a downlink. Then we need to specify the bandwidth $NR between BS1 and MS, MS to BS1, BS1 to MS, MS to BS1. So for each and everything we need to specify the bandwidth. And also always we are using simplex protocol. Simplex protocol means only one side alone transmission would take place. Then we need to specify the queue limit between BS and MS, MS and BS1, BS2 to MS, MS to BS2. So here also we need to maintain simplex protocol. So next one is, we need to give the queue size of the queue. So here queue red set summarize starts queue, starts underscore true, means that I am going to create a queue which is used to hold the packets which has been started from originated at the source end. Then afterwards I am going to create a topology. In topology first I have to insert a delayer, because directly a node cannot travel from source to destination. So I need to make a delayer between MS to BS1, BS1 to MS, MS to BS2, BS2 to MS. Then afterwards I need to specify TCP connection between all the nodes to start the transmission, because TCP is a connection oriented, so it will be reliable. So at 0.8 millisecond it need to start the transmission. Then by using the TCP we need to make a connection establishment between all the nodes, and we have to specify the window size. Window size is 100, and at 0.0 millisecond it has to start its simulation. At 8.0 millisecond it has to stop the simulation. And these are the coding is common for making the simulation, that is procedure stop. To finalize everything we need to write up this global nodes opt NF, NF stands NAMP file, and all the previously executed files need to be closed out. Then these are the things which are used for set the range between source and destinations. So after executing this we will get an output as like this. So thank you.